Mr. President, Board of Trustees, faculty, staff, graduates, family and friends, Nighthawk family. Today I would like to share with you some of the most important and life-changing words I have ever heard. In 2005, as I sat alone on my front porch, I found myself wrestling with God. Suicide attempt number 3 in progress from drugs and alcohol abuse. In that moment, what was to be a significant moment in my life, God spoke to me words that would change my life forever. He said, as audibly as you hear my voice, yet in the emptiness of my broken heart, he said, why are you taking your own life? He said, put your life into my hands and let me make something wonderful out of it. In a broken moment, I simply said yes. At that moment, I sobered up as if not a pill or a drink had been entered my lips. I trusted God's words as best as I knew how, which eventually led me to go to Kentucky Mountain Bible College. And there, as a broken man in need of some serious healing, I met a man by the name of Dr. John Nighthawk. For years, I pretended to be the guy that had everything all together, but he saw right through my mask on the very first day. And God used him to speak life and healing into my life from 2005 until his homegoing almost 2 months ago. One of the last conversations that we had, he told me, and I quote, seek the challenge to which God is calling you. Be certain that you can be all in, and then go in faith and obedience. It was encouraging words like this from my mentor and friend that God used to heal me spiritually, physically, and emotionally during my time at KMC, as well as my career at Wesley Seminary, pushing me to pursue God deeper daily. I began my journey here at Wesley Seminary in 2013, soon after Dr. John became president. His leadership and mentoring through the years following has kept me going, forcing me to never give up when I had papers due or other assignments to finish. Sorry. I had no idea in 2005 when I said yes to putting my life into God's hands that it would bring along such a person to see to it that I kept that yes. God has used him as well as many others in my life to keep me in God's hand. Since I said yes to putting my life into God in his hand, he has kept his promise of making something wonderful out of it. Check this out. Where once I was a sinner, broken and unloved, I am now saved and entirely sanctified. Woo! Where once I felt unloved, I am loved beyond measure. Where once I was lonely, I now have an eternal friend. And I'm now living in Jesus and have been given a beautiful wife. Amen. Where once I had zero hope, I now have hope of everlasting life in Jesus. Where once I had no purpose, I now have a purpose. I have been given that purpose as a shepherd to the people of Wesley Chapel, Wesley Church in St. Paul, Indiana. Since I put my life in God's hands, he has kept his promise of making my life into something wonderful. By setting me free from sin, by sanctifying me to his holy use, by giving me a beautiful life, an education, wonderful friends and family, a purpose, and a hope of everlasting life. Listen carefully to everyone in the sound of my voice. My desire for you, my urgent prayer for you all, is that you put your life into God's hands and let him make something wonderful out of it. If you're still in bondage to sin, let go and let God love you as he fully intended. In the name of Jesus. Let him free you from sin. Let him sanctify you to his will. If you are in God's hands already, flourish in his kingdom. Be on purpose for the gospel. Seek the challenge to which God is calling you. Be certain that you can be all in. Then go in faith and obedience. God bless you all. All right.